So I'm on my way out to meet a bloke that I haven't seen for 20 years. Now, I'm not sure how well this is going to go, but he's found something for me. Hopefully he doesn't want too much in return. And I spoke to him on the phone the other day and he gave me the address, and I'm only a couple of minutes away, and I've realised I've left that bit of paper with the address on it back at home. I did have a look on Google Maps when I was on the phone to him, so hopefully I can remember. Otherwise I'm going to have to ring him up and go, "Hey, what's your address again? I'm sorry, I've left that bit of paper at home." So hopefully I can find it, and hopefully I can get into the correct turning lane here, and hopefully we can do a good deal. And I can get this thing off him that he's been able to find for me from 20 years ago. I know I'm talking in riddles, but it sort of adds to the suspense of the video if I don't tell you quite what it is yet until I've got it in my hands. So, goal number one is to try and remember the address. I think is down here. So I think this is the street. Now, I don't remember what number he said, but I did have a look at the street view. So hopefully recognize the building when I pull up. So that's goal number one, is to find this place without having to ring him and say, "I'm an idiot, I forgot to bring a bit of paper with me." And then the second goal of the day is to get what he's found for me 20 years ago without him wanting too much in return. There it is. Alright, found it. Where will we park? I might just park across the road here, I think. Alright, hopefully this goes well. Alright, success. Wedding negatives from 20 years ago. Caught up with our photographer, Daniel, who did our wedding in 1999. We had to exchange a little bit of money, but these are all our negatives from 20 years ago. So, happy to finally have those. So my original plan, I started thinking about this a few months ago, back before Christmas. And I was going to get all those negatives digitized and dig out some of the video from our wedding and put together a video incorporating some of the professional photography and some home video from the wedding, and have that done for our anniversary. But the anniversary came and went last week. Almost to the day, Daniel, the photographer, called me up and said, "I finally found them after a couple of months of looking," because he's no longer in the wedding photography business. So he just had all these negatives from his old clients stored away at home. So I'm wrapped that he still had them and was able to find them. And apparently my wife had inquired about getting the negatives 10 years ago for our 10th anniversary, and he quoted her quite a bit. Whoops, no, you're turning. He quoted her quite a bit 10 years ago, and today he's been able to do it a lot cheaper because he's not in business. So happy with that. Not sure what the next stage will be. I'm going to have to find a scanner, I think, to digitise all these myself, because when I've had a look, companies that actually digitise negatives, it's so expensive. You're looking at between 80 cents and a dollar per image. So that's just phenomenal. So I might have to invest in a good scanner myself that is set up to scan negatives, and have a little project ongoing, probably over winter, and make it a rainy day project where I sit down and scan a lot of these negatives. So then once I've got everything digitized, hopefully I'll still then be able to get that old the old video footage that a friend of ours did on the home movie beta cam or whatever it was called, and put together something nice to remember our wedding. Anyway, happy to have these 35mm film, and also some medium format negatives. So we should be able to get some nice high resolution footage out of there. So happy with that. Time to head home. Well, we'll head home if these lights ever turn green.
Obviously not going to be able to do anything with these wedding negatives until I can invest in a scanner that can scan in good quality both the 35mm and medium format negatives. But I thought I'd finish off this video and show you some of our wedding photos. These are our albums. This is the proof album. So this has got lots and lots of photos in it. But I won't bore you with all of that. This one is the proper album that we've got. So let me show you our wedding photos. I won't take too long, I promise. It's not a slide night that'll take all night. Just give me a minute. All right, so this is our wedding album from February 1999. There's my wife's family, my beautiful bride. Okay, there's me 20 years ago, very young Simon, and my best mates at the time, Nick and John, that I don't get to see very often these days. That's my parents. Mandy arriving at the reception centre, the ceremony. That's my favourite photo. You can see some rice there that my father-in-law has thrown over us. just after we finish the vows. So wedding car.
I've forgotten all about this. I actually posed for a mock breakdown. I had the chauffeur put the bonnet up and we pretended to be broken down for a photo. At the time, I thought that was a good idea. I guess it's something different.
And just the usual standard sort of photos that you get with all the family. Some my bride and I. There we go. So, speeches at the reception, dancing. It's my late grandmother and aunt. We were married outside, but if it had rained, there was an indoor chapel that we could have had. And a lot of fun at the reception. The band actually had some crazy hats and outfits, and I wore a Superman vest for some of the night.
This shot here is actually a bit unusual. I actually insisted that our photographer got himself into one of the photos. So he had an assistant there helping, so he got a photo of his boss, which was our photographer Daniel, doing his job. So he's now part of our memories as well.
And there we are, leaving the reception. Alright, thanks for watching. I hope I didn't bore you too much with my wedding photos. Like I said, the original plan was to do something special using digitised versions of the professional photographers mixed in with some of the home video footage that was shot on the day 20 years ago. That didn't work out. I only just got the negatives today. It's a week after our anniversary. Still got to digitise those. So there will be another video coming up, maybe for our 21st anniversary. We'll see how we go. Thanks for watching. See ya.